Hey, what's up everyone? NeoCypher here with some more card opening videos. And it's time to go ahead and check out the Pokemon Sun and Moon Burning Shadows booster box. I have the Elite Trainer box, which I'll be doing later. So I'll get that off to the side here. First though, we're just going to be doing the actual booster box here. And as usual, I'll be doing 4 packs per video. Get that open, making it look nice for the video. So we'll go ahead and do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I can't count. There we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 packs. All right. Also got my binder here off to the side, so in between videos, I'm going to be putting cards in the binder, from a binder. Alright, so this hopefully will be a little more entertaining than the raw deal videos. Alright, so first pack here. Well, the packs are definitely harder to open than a raw deal, that's for sure. The side, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, had a little check something there. So of course we start off with our Sun and Moon obligatory pack energy card. I can't talk tonight. We have Curlia, Heatmore. Trying to find a good way to hold these. There we go. Weakness Policy, Stuffle, Crabrawler, Morlall, Sandygast, Venipede. The first holo for the pack is Araquanid. And the final card for this pack is an Azumarill. Or Azumarill, however you wish to pronounce it. Pronunciations were never my strong suit. Similar to never bumping into a tripod. Side 1, 2, 3, 4. We have a Fairy Energy. Then with Acerola. Again, pronunciations. Wobbuffet. Charmeleon. I like the design on Charmeleon. Morlul. Porygon. Meryl. Hoot Hoot. Rhyhorn. Reverse holo for the pack is an Espeon. And the final card for this pack is an Electross. I know I've already seen a couple of Electross singles at a couple different booths over at the exhibit hall here at GenCon. Speaking of singles, I mentioned that I picked up a couple more jungle singles. I'm down to 5, and I think they're all the ones that are like 10 to 20 bucks a piece or something like that. Alright, we have an electric energy. It's off the side a little more easier to reach. We have a Whirlipede, Tormenting Spray, Simisage, Crabrawler, Inkay, Ladybaw, Caterpie, Sandygast. First holo is a Simisage. And the final card for this pack is a Heracross. Oh man, I wish you were not region specific. Well, I guess you can call me region specific for Pokemon Go, though that region is Southern Florida. At least it's on the same continent. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4. Alright, fourth pack, we have a Grass Energy. Hey, we're actually getting different energy types. Lana, Seviper, Gloom, Riolu, back this up a little bit, Cutiefly, Tynamo, Duskull, Inkay. Reverse holo for the pack is a Riolu. And the final card for this pack is a Butterfree. Wait, bye-bye heal. Heal all damage from all of your Pokemon. Shovel this Pokemon on a card attached into your deck. Wow. So, Bye Bye Heal is essentially a scoop up from the original base set. Actually, I think Scoop Up actually only picks up the top card and goes back to your hand. I can't remember because I rarely ever use Scoop Up. I never really built any decks based around it. Alright. But I wonder if the Bye Bye Heal is a reference to the Pokemon episode Bye Bye Butterfree. It's probably just a coincidence. So we have a Water Energy. Plumeria. Super Scoop Up. Well, speaking of Scoop Up. Flip of Coins. If heads, put one of your Pokemon all cards attached into your hand. Guzma, Mudbray, Oddish, Duskull, Esper, Charmander, reverse holo for the pack is a Porygon, and the final card for this pack is a Scolipede. Not getting very lucky so far. Five packs and pretty much nothing but normal rares in terms of the rare card for the video, that is. Trying to recognize some of the Pokemon in the packs. I still do not recognize all the Gen 7 Pokemon yet. Four. Alright, we have a Psychic. We might actually go through all the energy types in one video here. Weakness Policy, Heat More, Tormenting Spray, Hoot Hoot, Rhyhorn, Ralts, Tangela, Dynamo, Reverse Holo is a Slowking, and the final card is a Weavile. Alright, next up here we have a pack I'm having trouble opening. And there we go. Alright, I finally get something good out of this. Probably just a normal, or actually, holo rare, none of my luck. We have a Steel Energy, Curlia, Ribbon B. From this angle, the M looked like an R and an N combined. Potown, Kerp. Wait a minute. Splashing Dodge. Flip a coin if heads, prevent all effects of attacks, including damage done to this Pokemon during opponent's next turn. 10 damage and the chance to prevent everything next turn. Wow. Alolan Rattata. Wimpod, Togedemaru, Sock, reverse holo for the pack is a Ribombi, and the final card for this pack is a Necrozma GX, full art to boot. Very nice. I have to actually look it up and see how much that's, I mean, it's going in my binder, just to see how much that is potentially worth. Just see what his GX move is here real quick. Also because I'm easily entertained by that. See, Black Ray GX, when this attack does 100 damage to each of your opponent's Pokemon GX and EX, this damage isn't affected by weakness or resistance. That's not bad. And in terms of play, you see, or at least the couple matches I've seen, you can see quite a bit of GX, or at least, at the very least, EX Pokemon. I don't know about GX. Starting off with a now we got duplicate energy. let's see, Ribombi, Sophocles, Seviper, Esper, Morlul, Charmander, Porygon, Meryl. Reverse holo for the pack is a Guzma, and the final card for this pack is a Slowking. Sorry, I was taking a look at Slowking's second attack here. Unarmed for 3 psychic energy and 110 damage. If you have no cards in your hand, ignore all energy and this attack's cost. Wow. So if you have no cards in your hand, disarmed, does 110 damage for nothing. I am curious if that's actually going to be good for like tournament decks and such. Not that I really follow tournaments. I'll occasionally watch them, but not enough to actually see what cards are good. Right, got ourselves a Psychic Energy there. Got a Solrock, Semipour, Bodybuilding Dumbbells, Meowth, Stuffle, Pansage, Krogunk, Pikachu. Reverse holo for the pack is a Gloom, and the final card is, are you kidding me? Another different Thecrozma GX. It's the same thing, but it's different art. Holy cow, are you kidding me? Now that's something that in a way kind of bugs me. Like I said, it's the same thing. It's just different art on the card. But it's the exact same card. If that makes any sense. But still. Wow, two Necrozma GXs. So that's pretty much it for the first video. Yeah. That right there, this may be the best of the four videos. First 9 packs, 2 GXs. So with that, I thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next time.